A. Adeboye came to Otukpo in government secondary school. He had come in 1978 and also came in 1979 to Otukpo, held a crusade. In that meeting in government secondary school, before he could open the scripture to start preaching, the Holy Ghost fell everywhere. And people were, I mean, it was an explosion. I was in that meeting. And that meeting was a drastic turning point. As a matter of fact, I went to one of the young men that came with him. And I had some discussions with him. And he encouraged and was talking to me about how to remain focused, how to remain on fire, how to study the word. That was 1978. Between 1978, 79, 80, we had gone with Brother Victor to villages on evangelism. We are talking about age 11, thereabout. We have gone to villages for evangelism. Are you following what I'm saying here? So I want us to understand a journey. And done all of that, and then young men, Brother Joe Ogbe, Joe Jesmel, Young Disciples Ministry in Lagos, he was also a product of that meeting. He was in the 3-day fast in Wesley High School. That continued the journey. My encounter with Pastor E.A. Adeboye was 45 years ago.
Hi, welcome to the Preacher's Portal. If you're new to this channel, please hit the like button, share, and subscribe. A document is already flying on the internet. Dr. Damina just released a newspaper publication of the Punch, Vanguard, and Abuja Times, revealing his role in the Dunamis CAC, Corporate Affairs Commission approval. That's the approval, the body that gives approval for a name for an organization or a business in Nigeria. And Dr. Damina was written as a member of the board of trustee, and that could show, like we can see in the document here, Dr. Polinache, his wife, and Dr. Damina, the three trustees. And you can see that is to show the kind of relationship or the cordial relationship they had in the beginning. To experience such a blotting out and nailing of the handwriting of Dr. Damina's impact or impute in his ministry, there must be a reason for it, and that is what we don't know. But however, in this video that we're about to share with you, he talked about how he encountered Christ way before he even met Dr. Damina, and that was under Daddy Gio, that's Pastor E.A. Adeboye, and also Daddy Kumuyi. We talked about the people that shaped him, shaped his spiritual life, shaped his prayer life, his Christian life. And let's listen to him, because this was way before meeting Dr. Damina. So let's listen to him.
E. Adeboye came to Otukpo in government secondary school. He had come in 1978 and also came in 1979 to Otukpo, held a crusade. In that meeting in government secondary school, before he could open the scripture to start preaching, the Holy Ghost fell everywhere. And people were, I mean, it was an explosion. I was in that meeting. And that meeting was a drastic turning point. As a matter of fact, I went to one of the young men that came with him. And I had some discussions with him, and he encouraged and was talking to me about how to remain focused, how to remain on fire, how to study the word. That was 1978. Between 1978, 79, 80, we had gone with Brother Victor to villages on evangelism. We are talking about age 11, thereabout. We have gone to villages for evangelism. Are you following what I'm saying here? So I want us to understand a journey. And done all of that, and then young men, Brother Joe Ogbe, Joe Jesmel, Young Disciples Ministry in Lagos, he was also a product of that meeting. He was in the 3-day fast in Wesley High School. That continued the journey. My encounter with Pastor E.A. Adeboye was 45 years ago. 45. After a season of some slight slackness spiritually, in the year of 1986, I rededicated my life to Christ in Deeper Life Campus Fellowship. I had an encounter overnight, and Deeper Life Campus Fellowship and Kumuyi is 38 years. I had an encounter overnight. It lasted from about 2 a.m. to 4 a.m. I won't go into detail because I see time is racing. The outcome of that encounter was my life completely handed over to God. And Lord, I am ready to do whatever you want. I went to the campus fellowship. Nobody was there. I cleaned out the chairs. Nobody told me. And then came and stood at the door and began to welcome people to the fellowship. I'm sure they were wondering, where did this new usher come from? What branch? I was from no branch. The zeal of God had consumed me. It was a driving force. I cleaned out the chair. Welcome to the people. In Deeper Life Campus Fellowship, we went all the way to Ayobo IBTC in Lagos for Deeper Life Campus Fellowship conferences. It was a forming moment. After a while, after doing that emergency ushering work, and then all of that, I joined the Deeper Life Choir. Deeper Life Choir director is now a pastor, and he's in Benin. We met Brother Omoro last time, and my pastor in Deeper Life then, Pastor Chris Obaji Makodi, was here for the dedication of the Glory Dome. Hallelujah. Now, that journey went until I stepped into the campus. Now, the first campus was an A-level. And now this was the full-fledged finish going for the university medicine. And as I stepped into the campus, now let me say something before stepping into the campus. Because I want this journey to be understood by you, because there are lessons to learn. After that A-level, I didn't get immediate admission. I had points that, I mean, I had more than cutoff point for medicine. So I had 1 year at home. That 1 year could be called my Bible school. Within that 1 year, there were days of 7 hours in tongues. Average. Within that 1 year, 7 days, no food, only water. And within that season, 7 hours of tonguing. We had a fellowship called the Ojira Fellowship, where iron sharpened iron. This Bishop Imai Jachi here tonight. He was in that fellowship. Bishop, you are sitting all the way there. Please come forward and let's create a seat. Where somebody shared, another shared, it was like bomb dropping. Young men on fire, on fire, on fire. By the time I stepped in, I'd like you to listen to this. By the time I stepped into the university, I arrived like a flame. I was studying medicine, but every morning before class started by 8 a.m., I would pray between 1 hour to 3 hours. Before, let me say something again. In that 1986, 87, we are already casting out devils. Already. So I entered into the university aflame. I will pray between 1 hour to 3 hours every morning. Sorry, I didn't plan to embarrass you, but you're welcome. We were doing rural evangelism. Huh? You remember how we climbed motorcycle?
Attack my mother.
We climb motorcycle to interior villages at Takpa and Moda, evangelizing ruggedly. You see, there are people who are in ministry today who have never done anything rural. They just want the glamour and the pulpit and the, your elegance, and I am seeing me big man of God. Attack by and mother, motorcycle back. You come into some communities, the whole place is tied down with darkness. Demonic possession and oppression everywhere. And mother, if you remember, take your seat. So when I was in the full-fledged university, I was already aflame, praying 1 to 3 hours every day, then went to class by 8. By 12 o'clock, I had burden for prayer again. After that is the break between 12 hours. In medical school, you are a medical doctor, you know what I'm talking about. Who does that in medical school? 1 hour to 3 hours pray in the morning, another 1 hour in the afternoon. You have to go and read. When the body got too much, I went behind the physiology laboratory, and then I'll be praying right there for using that 1 hour before the next class by 1. While I was in that praying at the back, I met a young man who was also praying quietly. Then as I prayed a little, I will share a little scripture with him. He exploded. I shared a little, he exploded. Brother Boniface Ochai is a medical doctor in Australia right now. So he told me, who are you and where are you from? I told him, I'm in 200 level. He said, really? What you are sharing with me, can you come and share in the general fellowship? He was the president of the Nigerian Conference of Christian Medical and Dental Students, our branch, NCCMDS. So he brought me to the fellowship. He said, please, we have a brother here who wants to share something with us. By the time I finished sharing, Sister Becky was there. With her thick glasses. Glasses was like Coca-Cola bottle. I was the one who removed it. I removed the glasses. She said, don't block your eyes like that. The glasses were so thick, she only removed it in the bathroom. That she can't go to the bathroom without it. With one prayer. So when I finished ministering to them, medical students, I stood on the altar. Everybody was on the floor. Receive on the floor. And I'm sure you know why we reduce that hand a bit. Let me tell you the story. In Area 1 church, we say receive. By the time service is over, 30 plastic chairs have broken. And that was what we had, plastic chairs. Another service, 50 plastic chairs. Pastor said, this is not economical. Let people begin to receive without breaking chairs.
Yeah, our conclusion in this video is, I think the beginning of the video, the beginning of all these things, I think it was not properly managed. That was just the truth. Because when the videos began to fly, when Dr. Damina said he ordained them, he ordained Dr. Paul Nenche, or he gave him direction to start the Dunamis Church. You know, if it was handled earlier, you know, come out and like appreciate the fact that, okay, this person played a major role, but there were a series of encounters or things I had that also gave me confirmation. I would not start this ministry. With the result of the ministry, you would certainly know that there is God's backing. You understand? Because the Bible says in the mouth of 2 or 3 witnesses, the truth is established. So certainly, no matter how Dr. Abel Damina says it, he's only a part of, you know, the process. That's just the truth. He is not the totality of the process. So if in a way he's trying to think that without his direction, Dr. Paul would have missed the direction, that's absolutely wrong. That's just the truth. God would have still spoken to him through another person. You understand? If God has insisted and called this man into ministry, which is very, very obvious, Dr. Paul is called, Dr. Paul is anointed for this generation. That is just the truth. No matter what you people say, Dr. Paul is an anointed vessel of God. He's an anointed man of God. So no matter what, even if Abel Damina did not hear from God, you know, and Dr. Paul went to London, God will still reroute him back to ministry. That's just the truth, and that's just it. So, but at least there should have been a point where Dr. Paul would just recognize the fact that Dr. Abel played a particular role, if indeed He actually did that. That's the truth. Because nobody has come to, nobody's his alibi, because the truth is Dr. Abel Damina, Dr. Paul Eneche, and the wife are the only three people in the particular setting where the direction was given. Then the ordination, Dr. Abel Damina has mentioned a lot of names. He has mentioned Padam Pasi Paul, he has mentioned Bishop, he has mentioned John Praise, he has mentioned a lot of people. And he said there were many people there in the day of the ordination. There are many people seated there. A lot of people are quiet. You know, nobody's coming to Dr. Abel Damina's aid to say, okay, I was there. Why are you not accepting that I was there? I guess they don't even want to get involved. So that's just the truth. Anyway, this was not properly managed from the beginning. That's just the truth. And if in any way Dr. Abel Damina is bringing out all this proof, you know, in order to make a point or something, or to gain traction or relevance, I don't think he said that's not his intention. But in a way, you understand, this could actually be playing to the crowd, be playing to the audience. That's just the truth. So the truth is, no matter what they do, the Church of God is marching forward. This will not bring any of them down. It's not bring Dr. Paul Nature down. It's not bring any man of God down. That's just the truth. But I think it's something that we also need to learn from here, how to address issues like this before it escalates, how to address issues public, how to address this kind of issues and calm it down. You understand? Yes. So it is well. Let's keep praying for the body of Christ. This is a Preacher's Portal. If you're new to this channel, please hit the like button, share, and subscribe.